Hi everyone. Now we are going to discuss about a topic called drug resistance or the drug tolerance. An organism, that is especially microorganism, that had once been highly susceptible to a drug or antibiotic or chemotherapeutic agents may develop resistance over a time. When this happens, the drug is no longer effective for clinical use. And the organism is said to be achieved drug resistance or drug tolerance. And the development of and spread of drug resistant pathogens is one of the most serious threats to successful treatment of microbial diseases. Now let's see the definition of drug resistance and then moving to the origin and transmission of drug resistance, and then we'll move to the mechanism, and then what are the prevention, that means how to prevent the drug resistance. So coming to the definition of drug resistance is the reduction in effectiveness of a drug in curing a disease is called as drug resistance. That means the reduction in effectiveness of a drug in curing a disease that was caused by a microorganism is going to be called as drug resistance, which can also be, in some terminology, we can call it as drug tolerance, which means when the drug is not intended to kill or inhibit a pathogen, and then the term is equivalent to dosage failure or drug tolerance. Okay, now the other definition of the drug resistance can be like this. The drug resistance refers to the acquired ability of a microbial pathogen to resist the effects of a therapeutic agent to which it is normally susceptible is called as drug resistance. Okay, now the drug resistance does not involve the host, that means we. Okay, our body do not have the drug resistance, but it is a function of the microbial pathogen present inside the host. So drug resistance is the one which is developed by the microorganisms, not by us. Now this antibiotic resistance is the ability of a bacteria to resist the effect of an antibiotic is called as antibiotic resistance, where the bacteria is not killed or their growth is not going to be stopped. Then we call that condition as antibiotic resistance. Now what happens when they are going to develop the resistance? They are going to survive an exposure to the antibiotics and continue to multiply in the body and potentially causing more harm. So generally it will cause harm, but as developing the resistance, we think that we are taking the medicine, but the bacteria develop the resistance and so obviously causes more harm and spreading to the other animals or the people. So this development and spread of drug resistant pathogens has become one of the most serious threats to successful treatment of microbial diseases. So let's see the origin and transmission of drug resistance. The genes for drug resistance are present either on the main chromosome or the plasmids. That means on the main DNA or the extra chromosomal material, that is plasmids. So the in the main chromosome, the drug resistance is going to develop because of the some spontaneous mutations. Okay, and so obviously what happens, the bacteria will make the drug resistant capacity. And then a bacterial pathogen is drug resistance because sometimes it's plasmid bearing one or more resistant genes. Such genes are going to be called as R plasmids. So here the R is going to be for resistance. Okay, and the plasmid bound resistant genes often code for enzymes that destroy or modify certain drugs. And the example is this, we are going to have some sort of drugs like chloramphenicol, aminoglycosides, and then penicillin, cephalosporins, erythromycin. So these all are going to be of having the resistance by the organism, that is microorganism, which are possessing the plasmid associated genes. Okay, so you can see this picture. Here are the two bacteria. One is a resistant bacteria which possesses the plasmid, the drug resistance, and the other one is a non-resistant bacteria. Now as we know, they will multiply. During the multiplication, what is happening is the genes are present on the plasmids and they are readily transferred to the other cell, that is cells, quite rapidly through normal gene exchange process such as our conjugation, transformation, transduction and transposition. Because a single plasmid may carry genes for resistance to several drugs, a pathogen population can become to several drugs simultaneously. Now the non-resistant bacteria is going to die, but the resistant bacteria is going to survive. So finally what happens? The drug-resistant bacteria is going to multiply and thrive in the presence of that concerned drugs or the antibiotics. So this is how the origin and the transmission of the drug resistant is going to occur. Then what is the mechanism that these bacteria are following to develop this drug resistance? So the microorganism become during resistance in several different ways. Okay, a particular type of resistant mechanism is not confined to a single class of drugs. That means two organisms may use different resistant mechanisms towards the same chemotherapeutic agents. And even resistant mutants arise spontaneously and are then selected. These mutants are not created by exposure to a drug. These are all the things that you have to remember. Then what are the different mechanisms that they are following is, number one, microorganisms may produce enzymes that destroy the active drug. For example, take the staphylococci resistant to penicillin G, produce an enzyme called as penicillin enzyme. So obviously it will destroy this penicillin drug. In the same manner, we are having the gram-negative bacilli, which is resistant to chloramphenicol, produce an enzyme called as chloramphenicol acetyl transferase enzyme, which will destroy the chloramphenicol drug. Okay, so this is how they are going to produce some enzyme which will destroy the active drugs. This is one mechanism. Then coming to the second mechanism, microorganism may change their permeability to the drugs. So what is meant by permeability to the drugs? They won't allow the antibiotics to inside to their cell. So obviously what happens? They cannot occur. That means microorganism may cease active uptake of certain drugs. Example, resistance to tetracyclines and polymyxins. Then the third one, microorganisms may develop an altered structural target for the drug. So for example, here you can see the modification. Microbial drug receptor sites are going to undergo some modifications in decrease. So obviously what happens? There will be decrease in the antibiotic binding and the antibiotic action. For example, check the erythromycin resistant organism have an altered receptor on the 50S subunit of the ribosome resulting from methylation of 23S ribosomal RNA. So in the same manner, resistant to some penicillins may be a function of the loss or alteration of protein binding, protein binding sites. So these are all going to be because of the third thing, altered structural target for the drug. Then we are going to have the fourth one, microorganisms develop an altered metabolic pathway that bypasses the reaction inhibited by the drug. So there are certain drugs which are going to be more structured in a way to alter the or stop the metabolic pathway. Now these microorganisms will bypass that blocked one. So that is going to be called as altered metabolic pathway. So example, some bacteria have developed resistance to sulfonamides by acquiring the ability to synthesize PABA, so PABA, by utilizing preformed folic acid. Okay, now the fifth one is going to be of microorganism develop an altered metabolic pathway that can still perform its metabolic function but is less affected by the drug than the enzyme in the susceptible organisms. So either it is going to have the bypass or it is going to just modify the metabolic pathway. It is not going to bypass, just it is altering some sort of the features. It is going to continue it, but it may be a little bit later, that is late for its function. But altogether, it is going to resist the drug. So one more here, you can see the pumping out. This is going to be called as efflux. EFFLUX. So the antibiotics are coming inside and they're being pumped out. So this is going to be called as efflux of the drug. So that kind of the increasing activity of active efflux of the drugs is also going to be one of the major mechanism of the drug resistance. So these are all the several mechanisms of drug resistance. So here you can see the antibiotic targets, that means how the antibiotics are targeted to kill the pathogen, and here are the, all the examples where how the antibiotic resistance was developed by microorganisms. So here the cell wall, so beta-lactam vancomycins are targeting or preparing targeting the cell wall of the bacterial cell, and whereas the microbial cells are going to have some sort of a efflux site of proteins to throw out the antibiotics from it, that's how it is going to resist. Then coming to the DNA or RNA synthesis is going to be stopped by fluoroquinones and rifampinils, and here it is going to be of target modifications. So there it is going to modify some sort of structural things and the enzyme. So obviously what happens, it is not going to have effect on its DNA and the RNA components. Then the folate synthesis, the PABA is going to be one of the factor in stopping the growth, but it is modifying it by inactivating the enzymes. Even the protein synthesis, which is also going to be of that means they are going to have a structural modification, they are altering the structure that is going to be targeted by the drug. So these are all the resistant mechanism that these microorganisms are developing, and that's how they are going to be of antibiotic resistance. Okay, so this is a picture, just I want to compare the antibiotics target in the manufacture and how the microorganisms are going to resist that antibiotic targeting. Now how to prevent this drug resistance or prevention of emergence or drug resistance? So there are several strategies which can be employed to discourage the emergence of drug resistance. So here are going to be some of them. The first one is going to be the indiscriminate use of antibiotics must be avoided. So that means we have to avoid the indiscriminate use of antibiotics. Then the second one, it is essential to use the correct dose. That means if the doctor is prescribing only 250 mg, if you are going to take a 500 mg, then it is a wrong way of using the dosage. Okay, so it is essential to use the correct dosage and as well as the schedule of the antibiotic to overcome the infection early. So this is the second one. Then coming to the third one, maintain sufficient high levels of the drug in the tissues to inhibit both the original population and the fastest step mutants. That is the third one. Then moving to the fourth one, use of mixture drugs, that is multi-drug therapy, have to be given such that they are going to act in the different modes of action. Next, fifth one, we are going to have the antibiotics used in veterinary practice can lead to the emergence of drug resistant strain that may be transferred to humans. How? Those who are going to have the consumption that may have transmitted to the humans too. Next. The next one is going to be of incorporation of antibiotics in the animal feeds must be controlled, because there's animals may cause to grow more rapidly, but associated with the increase of drug resistant strains in the farm workers also develop. Hence, we are supposed to have the use of antibiotics in the animal feeds must be controlled. Now, antibiotics, that means the drug of choice, have to be replaced at the first sign of resistance by the organism. So when we are having a doubt that the organism has developed the drug resistance, so immediately it has to be replaced. Then antibiotics should only be used in situations where a bacterial infection is either proven or strongly suspected. Next, the drug chosen should be targeted for the specific organism to be eradicated rather than opting for a more broad spectrum drug. So if we follow all these preventive measures, we can prevent or discourage the emergence of drug resistance in the microorganisms. So this is all about the drug resistance. Okay, thank you.